Yannick Sinner versus Hubert Hurkacz is the final for the men's event at the Miami Open for 2021. And both players have been very impressive this week to make it to the final. The number 21 seed Yannick Sinner came into this tournament with great hope, getting a bye in the first round. In the second round, he took on the Frenchman Gaston, beating him in straight sets 6-2, 6-2. His third round, he took on the number 14 seed Khachanov, and after losing the first set, had to fight for the win, eventually prevailing 4-6, 7-6, 6-4. In his fourth round, he took on fellow young gun Ruusuvuori and was very impressive, winning in straight sets 6-3, 6-2. In his quarterfinal, he took on the number 32 seed Bublek, and again, a straight sets win 7-6, 6-4. In his semifinal match, Sinner took on number 7 seed RBA, who had just beaten Medvedev, the top seed. And after going down in the first set, came through in a long match, eventually winning in 3, 5-7, 6-4, 6-4. Hurkacz arrived to the Miami Open as the 26th seed, had a bye in the first round. His second round match was against Kudla, the American, getting through in straight sets 7-6, 6-4. In his third round match, he took on the number 6 seed, Denis Shapovalov, but he flipped the script this week, winning in straight sets 6-3, 7-6. In his fourth round, he took on another Canadian, the 12th seed, Milos Raonic, and after losing the first set, had to fight to win in tight three-setter 4-6, 6-3, 7-6. His quarterfinal match was his best comeback to date against the number 2 seed Stefanos Tsitsipas. After going down badly in the first set and a break in the second, Hurkacz came back to prevail in 3, 2-6, 6-3, 6-4. In his semi-final match, Hurkacz would have to face another seeded player, the number 4 seed Rublev, and this was the Pole's most impressive win of the week, taking out the 4th seed in straight sets 6-3, 6-4. In his quarterfinal match against Batista Agu, Sinner hit 37 winners and 53 unforced errors, served up 5 aces, only 2 double faults, and converted 4 out of 8 break point chances. And he would need to limit the errors against Hurkacz in the final. In his semi-final against Rublev, Hurkacz hit 25 winners and 25 unforced errors, winning 9 out of 12 points at the net and serving 8 aces and only the 1 double fault, converting 3 out of 8 break point chances, and will need to play just as aggressive as he did against Rublev in the final against Sinner. These two have never met before on the ATP circuit, so this is going to be a first time of many, I expect, between these two. This is a tough one for me to pick because both players were not expected to make the final this week, but I've been really impressed with Hurkacz this week, so I'm going to back him to win the final against Sinner in 3 sets. Let me know down in the comments below, who do you think is going to win this final?